Now, I look at it this way. You have youth and power against veteran experience. Veteran experience has taken you many, many times to the title. What are you going to have to do in order to keep it?
I'm going to try to strike as much time as she strikes, because she's a striker. She's very, very good. I've watched her over the years, and she has been winning a lot.
Yes, she has. Any final thoughts before you start?
Oh, just throw strikes, hopefully make my spares, and that's it.
I wish you the best. Good luck. That belt is not new to you. You've worn it before. So, now, what's your thoughts in terms of getting it back?
Getting it back.
What do you need to do today in order to win?
Good shots. And high noons. Mm-hmm. Good shots.
So, you got a different jersey on the last time that I chatted with you. That was an Apex Predator shirt. It is now in a high-powered jersey.
It is.
I'm sure there's...
It is a change.
Sure there's a story behind that.
Not a story. Just, it's a change.
Good change. So, any other thoughts or anything that you want to say? I know a lot of people want to get into the match, so any final thoughts?
After the match, I will be playing mini golf.
Maybe with a belt?
Yes.
All right, sounds fun. Maybe I'll do a little mini golfing beforehand or afterwards. Good luck.
Thank you.
Anyway, this is a best of seven matchup. Whoever wins four games first will be walking out of here with the title. And I'm not going to say for the first time because both ladies have held the belt before. And I am joined right now by someone that I consider a very good friend and someone who's currently on the Northeast Vixens list. If you've seen some of the YouTube videos that are out there, especially from Europe, you know who she is. But she needs no introduction, even though I'm going to introduce her. This is Sarah Hood. Hey,
hello.
Sarah.
Hello, Gordon. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming. How are you enjoying yourself today?
I'm really excited to see what happens with this match.
All right, so I'm going to chat a little bit about both Vixens before they start their match. I'm going to start a little bit with the champion, Herminator, Long Island Hall of Famer, New York State Hall of Famer. She has worn, Shim and I have been trying to figure out how many times she's held that belt. She has undoubtedly has had the belt for the most amount of times, much longer than any other Northeast Vixen. We're counting at least six, seven times. Now, I know that you've been taking notes on both Vixens during practice. Any thoughts that you had about Hermie?
Well, Hermie, she's been throwing an eternity and a Zen soul in practice. Mm-hmm. By my eye, the Zen soul looks a little bit better through the pins, driving a bit more. So it'll be interesting to see whether she starts with that or whether she goes for the eternity.
Okay, very good. Now on the other side of the Hudson River, maybe, yes. We have Segura Wheeler. Segura Wheeler, a former Northeast Vixens champion, one of the powerhouse females that are from the DMV area. The DMV, long known for many long reigning Vixens champions, Segura is one of them. She's held a belt, I believe, over a year, year and a half when she had it last time.
Wow.
So, and she lost to someone also from the DMV. So she's never lost a belt to Hermie. She's never lost a match.
Interesting.
From Hermie.
Interesting.
So this is going to be very interesting. I know you got notes on hers too. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah. So Segura's got a few balls in the bag. She's thrown quite a bit in practice. She's got a big foot, an archetype, a purple reactive, and a hammer axe, and I think possibly an Envy Tour as well. I'm not quite sure what she's going to start with though. So.
All right. So. So Hermie right now is starting the match with seven spear in the first frame. This is game one for everybody that just joined us. So you didn't miss anything. You missed a spare. So this is a seven-game match. Whoever wins four games first wins the title. I'm pretty sure we're going to see seven here. Just my thought. Ooh, almost at 8-10. Very high-powered, shall we say. First shot leaves an 8-pin.
So she threw that purple reactive. She went for the hammer purple reactive. Very tight line into the pocket, just left the 8-pin. Good shot.
Yeah, ball looked buried. I didn't see anything wrong with that shot, did you?
I mean, 8-pins, sometimes it can be the ball deflecting a little bit,
mm-hmm.
but I wouldn't move off that. I'd give it another chance and see what happens.
All right, so it looks like she's going to make the spare. She will. So we got Mark versus Mark, both spares going into frame two. You can feel the energy here a little bit. This is fun. This isn't like shall we say, you know, there's, for some of the other Vixens matches that we've had, we have people chatting each other. This is just silent.
Yep.
To people just getting down to business. That's what it really feels like. It doesn't feel like a fun sporting match. It feels like a business transaction. It really does. Feels like a business negotiation. Second ball. Oh. Ball looks good to me. She trips a seven. No, she doesn't.
And I'm guessing Segura didn't like that purple reactive because she threw the archetype on that lane.
Yeah. She's seeing, obviously, we're looking at the lanes for that than they are. They obviously get to see the lanes closer. Now, let me ask you this question. As someone that's been in these sort of matches, how quickly are you to switch balls, to switch gear? Ooh. I mean, obviously, she's going real quick here.
She made a very, very quick change. It could be that she's decided the lanes are playing slightly differently, and it was her intention to throw different balls on different lanes. Or it could be that she just made a very quick decision. I tend to be a bit slower in making decisions and possibly leave it a bit too long to change balls. Sometimes you've got to listen to your gut a bit more.
Understood. Segura Wheeler right now, two spares, 19 in first frame. Strike here from Hermie. She'll take a quick lead. That ball's, that's a little high. Ooh. And she does not trip out the four. I thought she was going to for a second. She did not.
So Hermie started with that eternity on the left-hand lane and didn't make the five. She left the bucket. Mm-hmm. So she's swapped balls for her second frame as well and swapped to the soul, which just drove a little bit high. Left her a four pin.
All right, looking for the spare here. She'll make it.
Good conversion, yep.
Yeah, both bowlers getting down to business very quickly, automatically changing equipment.
Yeah.
And we're only in the second frame of game one.
Yes, yes. I expect there'll be a few more changes to come throughout the upcoming games.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of changes, I think. Especially, again, both women know their equipment.
So, there we go. So Hermie's stuck with the Eternity on the left-hand lane. So I think the ladies are seeing the lanes slightly differently.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if maybe, I'm not sure which way around, but they're obviously seeing something different between the two.
All right, so right now, Hermie. Leaving it looks like the 4-5. Up there, her second shot. Right now, 19-19 all. 37 second frame for Hermie, assuming that she's going to make the spare. She does.
And that's a good spare conversion there.
Yep. One of the things that I like about the Vixens matches more than I do about the heavyweight matches, and I've always said this, that I prefer covering Vixens matches over heavyweight matches. For starters, it is for the women, it is a spare game, but they also have a much better spare conversion rate than the guys. No offense to the guys.
I mean, that's not just a UBA thing. People say that universally about the lady bowlers, is that we make our spares.
It's one of the reasons why your Cruiserweight champion is a female, Leah Maynor, because she can spare. She's got power, but she can spare all over the place. And that's how she won the title.
So Segura right is going with the archetype. Good
shot. Ooh, that ball looked good. Now, that looked like a ball change also. Talk to me about that.
So she threw that ball on the left-hand lane, and she's obviously liking what she saw on the left-hand lane, stuck with it for the right-hand lane. It's a big, solid A-sim. She's maybe thinking that the hammer reactive, which is a higher RG ball, that was going a bit long maybe, so she wanted something to read a bit earlier, I'm guessing.
Yeah, first strike in the match for either bowler right now. And right now, Segura Wheeler up by two, looking to make a 12 with the double right here. She can hit it. She does.
Good ball. That was a great ball.
Almost felt like a little bit that first couple of frames was like, yeah, a little tentative. Those last two shots were, okay, I know where the ball's going. I'm drilling it now.
Yeah, I think they're settling down a bit now. Playing the lanes very tight, keeping a pocket in front of them.
Right, Hermanina right now. Now all of a sudden, what she's got to throw pretty much needs to be a strike this early, and it is.
Well, that was better. That ball picked up a lot better than it did on the left-hand lane. It looks like she got it out to the right a bit earlier.
Feels like a business convention, doesn't it? Neither lady is talking. You don't see a lot of emotion. I mean, obviously, it's early. It's game one.
It's very early, yes.
But both bowlers very experienced. Both bowlers knowing exactly what they're doing. On this, I completely expect this ball to be flush for Hermie right now. Fifth frame coming in. That ball looks good.
Yes. That was a brilliant answer to Segura's double there.
Yeah, here we go, shall we say.
Yep. Both ladies, if they are nervous, they're masking it very well, I must say.
Yeah, well, both bowlers have been here before. Both ladies know what they need to do, and they're really good at it. And it wouldn't shock me if we see another 5-6 strikes consecutive from both ladies at this point.
Indeed.
I've said it many, many times. This is fun. Vixen's match is, for me, much better than the heavyweights. Kira Wehrle, that ball looks good.
Yes.
Beautiful shot.
Yep.
Buried.
There's not much we can say about that.
I mean,
if she keeps doing that, she's going to be hard to beat.
Yeah, both bowlers right now are going to be really hard to beat. You've got a match coming up with Kelsey Hammond, who actually had the belt, which Hermie took. So you're going to be bowling her. And should you beat her, you're going to be bowling one of these two ladies over
yes.
here eventually. Or maybe both of them eventually. Hermie's like, oh, really? Yeah.
Ball picked up really nicely there. That's another strike.
Yeah, it's a gear of four in a row. Meanwhile, Hermie was saying, yeah, she's really good. She's held on to the belt for a long time. Yeah, but so is Hermie. I mean, these are two... veterans, I hate to say that word because that word means that word means old and decrepit, and both bowlers are anything but. Uh-oh, that ball's a little bit high, though. Ooh, 4-7.
Yeah, that was a little bit, I'm guessing that was a little bit inside her mark. Didn't quite pick up the lane. Didn't really hit the pins in the right way.
Yeah, now Hermie, who is already trailing by 12 before the run of strikes happened. This case, now she's going to be down theoretically by around 34 pins, assuming she makes a spare. And she will.
Yeah, confident conversion there.
Yeah, one of the other things that I've noticed frequently about these Vixens matches, not a lot of opens. It's not like the heavyweights where it's feast or famine.
Yeah.
The Vixens, even if you're not striking, you are sparing.
Yeah. I mean, as long as these ladies can keep leaving makeable spares and they don't, you know, if they don't leave anything too messy, we're going to see a good match.
Oh, absolutely. And there's another strike. So Hermie would like that last shot in the sixth frame back, and now she's going to need some help from Sagira. If Hermie goes out the door, she goes for 245. Sagira can go out the door 249. Actually, no, it's got to be higher than that. I'm sorry, 279. Yeah, I'm like, wait a second. What are we doing here? I miscounted by 30 pins. Sorry about that. See, right now, regardless of what the number is, Hermie needs Sagira to not throw a strike very soon, because if she gets to the 10th frame and 7th and 8th and 9th frames are strikes, this game's over. 7th frame coming up in the first frame. Sagira up. Ooh, 10 pin. Now, all of a sudden, Hermie can breathe a little bit of a sigh of relief.
It's yeah, that's a little opening for Hermie there.
Yeah, Sagira can really, really could have stretched this game out. She does not.
So Sagira's going to pick up her hammer axe here to take out the 10-pin.
Mm-hmm. Assuming that she does that, that will give her 168. She can go out the door for 258. So the difference now, 13 pins. In terms of max score, 268, 245. And we're saying, assuming that Sagira is going to make the spare, that ball looks beautiful, it is.
Yep, solid 10 pin.
Again, Vixen's really good for making spares. I'll say this, heavyweight matchup, our current heavyweight champion, Jonathan Dansbury, if you saw that 10 pin, it'd be like, uh-oh, this could be an adventure. And I say that much love to Jonathan Dansbury, and I say that, however, I speak truth. Woman right now, again, you're looking at, if both bowlers goes out the door, the low game will be in the 240s. And if we're going to get this game won, this is going to be fun.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. You're railing right now. Looking to regroup. Eighth frame coming up. Also keeping with the same ball. Ooh, another 10-pin.
Back-to-back 10-pins.
Tell me about that shot.
Do you know, to me, both the shots look pretty good. The ball picked up, maybe the shot on lane three just went a little bit longer, didn't pick up quite as early. Mm-hmm. Just left her a 10-pin. It's a good shot, though. As I say, if you're keeping it in a pocket, you're staying in the pocket, you're not leaving anything too difficult, you're keeping yourself in the game.
Yeah, the only slight danger for Segura right now is the lead is now 2 pins. That is assuming that she's going to make the spare. If she does not make the spare, Hermy can double and take the lead. So important spare shot coming up here for Segura Wheeler. Looks like she got it. She does.
Yep.
So Segura's guaranteed to stay up by at least 2 pins going into her 9th frame. She cannot be shut up by Hermy. That being said, Hermy needs to throw a couple of strikes, and she needs to do it now. She's running out of frames. 8th frame coming up. Out of a white now. That ball looks good to me. It is. Everything goes down.
So that was slightly better than her last shot on the right-hand lane. So the last touch shot on the right-hand lane, it went a little bit left. That looked tight, but it carried. So possibly she made a little adjustment there just to get it back into the pocket.
Here right now it says 22 pins. However, because of the double, it's only a 12-pin margin, and a strike here makes it a 2-pin margin. It also forces Segura to start throwing strikes and not leave 10 pins in the 9th and 10th frame. Here you go.
Oh,
there's
she's
that
throwing
shot.
That right. And it's carried.
Beautiful shot.
It was. I don't know if it's what she intended, but yep, it's done the job.
You don't think it was she intended. It was it's, what she intended. Talk to
no,
me about that.
So compared to, again, if these lanes are playing differently, that could have been intentional. Mm-hmm. But her line on lane 4 is very, very tight based on that last shot, whereas the shot on lane 3, she got that out to the right. And it picked up and came back into the pocket. It could have resulted in a washout, but it didn't.
All right, going back to Segura, as I mentioned previously, this ball must be a strike or she will lose the lead to Hermy in the 9th frame. And Hermy is notorious for this. So it's got to be a strike. It's got to carry. It does.
It's a brilliant shot, very powerful release. Projects the ball out onto the lane really nicely.
So here's what it boils down to. In the 10th frame of game one, Segura, she goes out 247. If Hermy goes out 245, difference is 2. In order to shut Hermy out, Segura needs strike 9 in the 10th frame. Anything less than that, and Hermy can come into either tie or steal game one in a game that she was trailing since the 3rd frame. Segura, first ball here. That ball's high, tight, buried.
Brilliant shot there under pressure.
Well, that's a huge shot for Segura because that means even if she does not throw a strike here and gives Hermy a shot, Hermy's first ball's got to be a strike.
It's always a relief when you can get that first strike in the 10th frame.
And obviously, if she gets good count here in the 10th frame, even if it's not a strike, it will force Hermy to double. If she gets a strike and then 9, it doesn't matter what Hermy does. Hermy's dancing around with the music. That is silly.
She is.
Now the question is, will Segura be dancing after this shot? Yes, she will.
Samina look like identical shots to the one before. She's locked in.
Oh yeah, that looks good. If she leaves another 10 pin, that will still be 9. That will still be enough to give her game one. So, yes, I've heard her coach over there saying one good shot, and he's absolutely right. One more good shot, she wins. Big shot here. This determines game one. Keep in mind, Segura has thrown nothing less than a 9 in the first ball this mm-hmm. whole entire game.
Very high first ball count now.
Shots for game one. That ball looks good. It is.
It looked a touch inside, but it hit good.
Segura Wheeler, 247, and that will be good enough to take game one. Challenger strikes first. What a heck of a game.
There we go. There's a wrapped 10-pin on the right-hand lane.
You know, she knew that she was locked out. How much of that was actually throwing the ball, and how much of that was an area check? Yeah. So actually, Sarah, so let me ask again. I know that you were speaking to our stat guy, Carl Buckley, over there. Our stat guy and ball motion expert, Carl Buckley, who has joined us. And it didn't matter. It's like an ooh, but it really didn't matter. So at the end of game one, Segura Wheeler 247, Hermie Hannibal 212. The challenger leads 1-0. And the challenger will also start game two. She's having a seat. She's like, nope.
She was going to try and sit down,
but she was going to try and sit down, and then she shook her head going, oh, no, Gordon's right. I got to throw the ball. So anyway, I saw that the stat guy was throwing down some notes here.
Yeah, he was just making the same observation that you had, that Segura hadn't left anything lower than a 9 throughout the whole of that first game. So she's holding the pocket really well. Which is going to go in her favor. She looks more confident. Her ball roll looks a little bit better. There we go, another 10 pin.
Yeah, and by the way, I mean, despite the 10 pin miss by Hermie, which was much more of a or whatever than a miss.
Yes.
Yeah, I don't think that was an intentional miss.
Yeah, and I definitely wouldn't let that get to me in this position.
Absolutely not.
Yeah.
Clean game one. I mean, if you're Hermie Hannibal, not really much of an adjustment, really. The only reason why you didn't win the game was you left a couple of 10 pins. And Segura didn't. Segura finishes out with 5 strikes in the last 7 frames. Ooh. That looked a little bit interesting. Makes a spare, no problem.
Yeah, nope, it looked like a good spare. That hammer axe works well for her into that corner.
Yeah, no issues with 10 pins for either lady, and I say that despite the open from Hermie, because you and I both know that wasn't really an open. That was whatever. All right, let's see what Hermie learned from that 10th frame.
So Hermie's sticking with that Eternity Pie, but that's not rolling through the pocket at all well right now. You've left a 5-pin. It's
we know about 5-pins.
We all know about 5-pins.
You've left a couple yesterday, but you made them. You did not miss.
I did. I made my 5-pins at my UBA match yesterday. It was one of the most intimidating shots I've thrown in a while.
Uh-oh. No, she got it. I say uh-oh in jest. That ball wasn't going anywhere. No, but by the way, congratulations on Messenger Mafia, 3rd place in New Jersey Northeast Division.
Thank you.
And Kat, a nice little win yesterday, 28-12, so congratulations on that.
Yes. Really glad to come out of that, especially with some of the issues we have with the lanes.
Yeah, so it just matters. She's
just swapped to that Zen Soul, which I'm guessing she didn't like the ball reaction on lane 4. So she's changed the ball. It's just going to read a little bit earlier, hook a little bit more, drive through the pins a little bit more, I hope. And she's going to stick with the same ball, flatten her hand out to go across the lane for the spare.
Looks like she'll make the spare. She does. We're chatting a little WCS rules in terms of what's going on. Because, you know, Segura, by the way, in terms of not just being the number one contender for the belt, is also doing the World Championship Series coordinating. So she's going back and forth. She's multitasking. And since I was one of the people that used to be doing that, she and I are comparing notes. So we're chatting about a possible infraction, which is not an infraction. Sometimes in the UBA, just as in life, sometimes if we're losing a game where we're losing, we're trying to find little ticky-tacky rules, and no. I don't like ticky-tacky rules. Do you like ticky-tacky rules, Sarah?
No.
I like stuff settled on the lane. Right now, Segura looking to settle it on the lane with a strike. That's a Dara.
So she got that wide. She threw that right very early. It picked up the lane, hooked through the nose for a 6-pin.
Yeah,
she didn't post the shot. I'm assuming she won't be happy with that.
Yeah, that ball, there should have been a lot more pins up there besides the 6-pin. You're right on the 6. There should have been a 6 count, not 6-pin. Yeah. So gets away with it. Assuming she makes a spare, it will be tied.
So again, the lady starting off with spares, just grinding it out.
And again, something that the Vixens do that the heavyweights don't. Yeah, I'm picking on the heavyweights here, but I've done enough heavyweight matches to know that at this point, we would be seeing wide left, wide right, arg. People slamming balls, doing stuff, having chats with their towel. No offense to anybody that I'm mentioning, but you know darn well I am correct on this. Both Vixens cool.
Yep, neither of them showing signs of frustration yet either.
No. Oh, much better ball. There we go.
So Segura changed ball there. I don't know what she changed to. But yeah, she's obviously not liking the archetype right now. Maybe it's just going a little bit long, not quite picking up. So she's probably just balled down. So Anne Hermes changed ball as well. So she's gone to a roto grip duo as a bigger asim ball, and she's carried. Looked a lot better shot on the right-hand lane, had a little bit more shape to it, wasn't as tight into the pocket. Let's see how it goes on this left-hand lane.
Sorry about that, I'm multitasking, doing more multitasking as well. Hannibal right now, look for the double, that ball looks good, it is.
Yeah, that was a great ball change, that.
You know, I know that right now, Segura's sort of focused on her team. Her team is also bowling today. The tour stop, and that's been one of the issues that's popped up, but she's got to be focused on that match. If she loses focus, she will lose game two.
And that's a really tough place to be. That's a really tough place to be, having your mind elsewhere when you're trying to bowl a match. I think that's an Infinity. Brunswick Infinity, it looks like.
Yeah, I mean, we've all been in that position where we're bowling something, and then all of a sudden something else happens. Like, oh, wait, why is my mind having to focus over here? It's a better shot, though. That ball's not going to go up high. Gets the mix.
That was a lucky shot. That didn't quite pick up as well. Could be that she maybe needs to move it a little bit left, change the angle a little bit, just get it to pick up and drive through the pins a bit better.
Yeah, one of the things that I noticed on that shot, and comparing the two shots, in the second frame, that ball went real high. And the third ball, it almost looked like that she went light. And you said it's a lucky shot, and I don't disagree with you. Where should that ball be going? Oh, I mean, besides in the pocket, har.
Well, I mean, on these house shots, you want to get it out to the dry, but it's, there's going to be, it's okay, so.
Well,
she's going to reset.
Yeah, it's going to reset. Fortunately, the ball went in the correct direction, which was away from the foul line. The ball went in the opposite direction, which is towards the foul line. That would have been a foul, and that would have been a really bad thing for this game. that could have been on a dumb waste of dive video. But it's not.
Good shot. Projected it out onto the lane really nicely. That was a really pressure shot. She dealt with it really well.
Yeah, that's how to reset correctly. Okay, let me ask the girl, what were you trying to do on that shot?
No, I just dropped it.
Okay.
Nothing special.
Donk.
There we go. Look at that duo. That's picking
Hermes
up a lot better than the Eternity Pie was. She got the flat 10 off it, so maybe it needs a little bit adjusting. But she's in the pocket. It's good.
Yeah, temping up there.
And there she's going back to the Zen Soul. She's going to flatten it out to take out the temping. Good spare.
No problem. But once again, just like game one, Hermes finding herself trailing here game two. A little bit later in game two, but still trailing with the exact same issue.
She is
a flat 10, and Segura's
not.
But
she made it up. She made it back. She made it competitive in the first game, and I'm sure she's going to do the same right now.
I agree with you on that.
So that's gone, again, that's gone out to the right a little bit earlier. Bit more shape on the ball. Drove through the pins really nicely.
Yeah, Segura, Hermie Hannibal can go out the door 258. Segura Wheeler, once again, spare out the door 279.
Yep. It's a very close match. It's a very high scoring match.
Yeah. You may have to deal with Miss Wheeler in a couple of months.
Oh. We'll worry about that when we get there.
Yeah, I was going to say, first things first, you got to get past another Northeast Cruiserweight Vixens champion. Here, Will, that ball looks.
Oh, she like that. Oh, there's she a tap gets on a temp the 10.
Down.
So it's looking, her line's looking a bit tighter with this Infinity on the right hand lane. See whether she makes any adjustments with it. They definitely seem to have more area on the left hand lane. Mm-hmm.
Wheeler right now, four in a row, looking to make it five, and
oh,
she does.
There we go. She doesn't like it, but I'm sure she's going to take it.
I don't think she's going to say, give it back, let me drop the ball again. I don't think she's going to give us that. She said, nope, I'll take my five in a row, thank you very much. Yeah. Left is 10-pin, that messenger down, 7-pin, that messenger down. Hermes shot's a little bit high,
that was
Barry.
A great shot.
Well, that is a beautiful shot. And if this is, in the words of Yogi Berra, this is deja vu all over again.
She's under a lot of pressure here facing a five bagger. So for her to pull that out of the bag, this is excellent mental game from both ladies here.
Yeah, she's got to pull something out of the bag. Eighth frame, she's running out of frames. It's got to be a strike here.
There we go. See that ball just goes further right. Ooh. Ooh, she got away with that one.
Well,
the ball just goes further right on that left-hand lane, so it's driving higher through the nose. Nearly left had a big split, but the 10-pin fell.
Yeah, she was not happy about that. That may be the first sign of frustration in this game. The 10-pin went down, but to be completely honest, that 10-pin may as well stayed up.
And that Eternity Pie just didn't quite pick up enough to take the spare.
Yeah, I think that was a frustrating spare shot. She knew that had to be a strike in the eighth frame. She's got a 164. The best she can do is a 224. And that puts no pressure on Sagira whatsoever at this point. Theoretically, she does not need, well, she's got to get one mark along the way. Obviously, if she strikes in the eighth frame, this game's going to be close to being over.
So I think Sagira's struggling a little bit with her thumb hole fit right now. She dropped the ball, obviously, on the left-hand lane a couple of frames ago. She wasn't happy with that last shot on the left-hand lane.
See right now, any strike here is going to be good. 10-pin.
Flat 10.
Now again, she doesn't have to make the spare, even though I'm saying that I'm going to get a stare. Like, yes, she does. Needs to make the spare.
I mean, mentally, I wouldn't want to be missing it, even if I was safe.
No.
I wouldn't want to be putting myself in that position where I've got that doubt in my head.
Well, yeah, I mean, mentally, you want to shut the door at this point.
Absolutely.
You know, the game's not mathematically over. She's got, oh, she'll make the spare.
Yeah.
You know, she's got a little bit of wiggle room here. She does not have to mark out in both the ninth and the tenth. She does got to get one of them, though. So best term he can do is a 224. Any sort of mark, actually not any sort. Strike nine open will give her a 226, which again will more than cover the 224. You know, I look at it from a mathematical geek standpoint. You're looking at it as a Buller standpoint,
oh, definitely,
obviously.
Yes.
And
yes.
Call the back is just shaking his head going, Gordon, what are you doing?
That was a great shot. Yeah.
Beautiful shot. And what that basically means also now, that basically means is she does not need a mark. A nine count, assuming that Hermie goes out the door, a nine count in a combination of both balls will be good enough to seal it up. Anything less than that, like if she hits a big four, all of a sudden that becomes interesting.
Yep. That but definitely swings it around.
Yeah, first things first, Hermie's got to go. Hermie may not realize. Nah, she hasn't realized.
She's just dancing. She's dancing. She's happy.
Well, you know, again, if I'm Hermie, I still need to throw a couple strikes, put some pressure. You never know what's going to happen. You know,
and again, you want to have that confidence in the ball and what you're throwing. So she's gone back to that Eternity Pie. It's still not really picking up the lane very well. Still not taking out the five pin.
Yeah, now mathematically the game's over. But if she threw a strike, you never know. If you remember, Siguri threw that ball high up there in the second frame. She couldn't lift a big four in that shot. She does that again, and all of a sudden you got a, got a ball game.
It's a very different match, yes.
But it doesn't matter. Mathematically, the game's out.
Hermie, there we go. Makes a conversion.
Now, you're Hermie at this point. You obviously know this is going to be an area check, the 10th frame. What ball are you pulling out there? What are you using? Or are you pulling out something different?
Personally, I still think she needs to try that Zen Soul. She left that four pin in the second frame, I think it was, of the first game. And I would take that ball back out and move a little bit left.
What ball is she taking out right now? Is that the Zen Soul or something else?
No, that's not the Zen Soul.
Ooh, we got something different out there.
Looks like it could be... might be an exponent. I'm not sure. Oh. No?
Whatever ball she took out there, that went
effortlessly
into the
pocket.
It
did the job.
Second ball coming up.
That's picking up a lot better than the Eternity Pie was.
It did. She left a 10 pin, but I absolutely agree with you. That definitely had a much better look going in the pocket.
Yes. Could be a phase five. We're not sure. Could be that it's a shinier ball. Maybe it's just going to get down lane a little bit better.
Well, spare ball, no problem.
Cross lane at the 10 pin. Good conversion.
So the only question now in this game, we know Sagira's going to win this game. We know she's going up 2-0. And we know that Hermie's dancing.
She is.
Oh, we're trying to find out from.
It is a phase five, yeah.
All right. All right, so Sarah correctly got the bowling gear together.
Oh, that was our stat guy, that one.
Sagira right now is chatting over there in the back. So now we're having a little intermission.
So Sagira has already sealed this game up. So the decision now for her is, does she want to try something else?
I'm going to be cracking open my
laptop
and going through that rule book.
Again, she's still not left anything less than a 9 count.
Because there's a question over here. Obviously, I'm doing the match. I have no say in terms of the rules or anything else. But everybody does know that I've got a copy of the UBA rule book on me. So Sagira right now finishing this out. Any distraction that she has currently right now looks like that it is focus.
It's
not distraction, and now it's focused on I am channeling my energy.
So she's just grabbed a different thumb out of her ball there. And I think she's going to throw her Envy Tour. Just see what that ball motion looks like, whether she's got any options to move into. That was a brilliant shot. The ball drove through the pins really nicely. And she's just going to throw the Infinity just to close out the game here. I expect she'll start the next game with that Envy Tour. See the deflection on that shot? Just a little bit at the end of the lane, the ball left through the deck, through the 9 pin. The Envy Tour, to me, drove through the pins a lot better.
Yeah, at the end of game two, Sagira Willer 258, Hermie Hannibal 204. Sagira is up 2-0. Now, based on the looks, were you expecting to see 2-0 from Sagira at this point?
No.
And Carl puts up, once again, Carl's absolutely right. Sagira has not thrown anything less than a 9 count during the whole entire match. Everything from Sagira has been either 9 spear or strike so far through two games. If that's not showing dominance at this point, I'm not sure what is. And Hermie starting out with another flag 10 pin.
Again, it's just not, I don't think she got it out to the right enough on that lane. They've got area on that left-hand lane that they can play with. And I think if she threw it out a little bit earlier, got a little bit more shape on it, it would drive through the pins a little bit better.
Yeah, Sagira Willer right now averaging a 250 for the first two games, 242, 248.
She is, yes.
So, she could theoretically, which would be fun to see, go 1,000 for four games.
She could do.
Right now, she's
on that
line.
She absolutely could do. I wouldn't want to be on a receiving end of that, I'm sure.
So yeah, we're gonna see. I hear UBA rules chatting going on in the background. So.
There is, and that's we're gonna see now how Sagira deals with this.
Yeah, we've been hearing now Sagira is again dealing with her own team issues, and again Focus has got to stay in the lanes. Yeah, she's up 2-0, but you really don't want to be having a letdown. And the one thing you don't want to do, you do not want to have at least 6-7 times UBA Vixens champion get back into a match.
Oh my God, no! You do not want to let Hermie back into this. You want to keep that momentum going. She's stuck with that Infinity.
There
was nearly a 5. The 5-pin was very late on that shot.
5 and 7.
Yeah, the 5-7 was there a long time.
Maybe the best thing for her is to be chatting right now, because I'm sure the adrenaline's up. She's like, oh.
Yes. Yep. And that's as well. When you start throwing these big games and your adrenaline starts going, you can start speeding up.
That's true.
That's my tendency. You speed up, the ball doesn't read the lane as well.
Oh, mine too. Oh, she smashed the pins down. Turnover for Sagira. We've got Angry Wheeler.
Coming out the gates firing here with a double.
Yeah. Now, Sagira, quick question. How much of those last two strikes was, I am frustrated with what's going on and I am taking it out on the lanes right now?
A little bit.
Yep, she agrees.
Yeah, we saw that immediately. That tighter line
on the right-hand lane.
Went up significantly.
The third game when you lose about 167 to be complaining about rules. I'm gonna need money to get
this
together.
Well, we'll chat a little bit. Oh, we did mention that the UBA bullies here do have some personalities, right?
Oh yes.
Oh, that looks good to me. Oh, that was a good shot. Down to seven.
So I suspect she's moved a little bit left. She's trying to play the hold on the left-hand lane rather than playing it out to the right. Both very tight lines, but she's carried both of those shots. That's what she needs to do.
More importantly, Hermie has started early this game. First two games have taken her a little bit to start striking. She starts striking now in second frame. She's waved her glasses. They're off now. The gloves are coming off. The glasses are coming off. That's how we're doing. This is a rated G broadcast.
Okay, so it looks like she's been wearing a new pair of glasses. She's not quite used to it.
Ah, three in a row. I'm coughing because I'm trying to stop myself from laughing at this point. Three in a row for Sagira. Still with that 10-pin lead over Hermie going into the fourth frame. Fourth ball coming up, looking for four in a row. Those shots were fast and buried. Like, she put something behind them. It's no longer tentative Sagira at the beginning. It is powerful, I am angry, and whoever kicked her off over to VMV, she may have to thank later. Okay.
There we go. That was very tight on the head pin.
We mentioned a name that we're not going to be putting up on this there, but she sort of did mention the nickname when we were talking to her, so if you're in UBA land, you sort of know. And I'll just say that's a former Northeast Heavyweight Champion who apparently ticked her off. So, I don't know, we could see a little match between those two. That could be fun. Hermie right now looking for her own fun four in a row. Bang!
That was nice. That looked like she played it out a little bit further right than the last shot on that lane. But she's got area on that lane for sure.
Yeah, by the way, only two opens in the game, in this match, both by Hermie. And again, putting this back out there, lowest count, 9 spare Sagira Wheeler.
Yep.
And she looks locked in at this point. Now, I'm also known as a dark cloud. That could be the kiss of death for me, that being said.
Commentator's curse.
I won't do the real cursing where it's, but we all know what I'm implying. Right now, looking for 5 in a row. That ball looks good to me.
That was brilliant. That was
buried.
A really nice shot. Drove through the pins really nicely.
Now, here's a scary thought here. She's got a 242 game one. What if that's her low game for the series? Think about that for a second. That 250 average may go up. And for Hermy right now is well over 250 herself.
Yep. It looks like she's just been waiting for that ball, being patient, waiting for it to pick up a bit better. She's trusted in it, and she's getting the results for it now.
Oh, there's that ball. That ball is tight again. Six in a row for
Sagira Wheeler.
Just absolutely
demolished the rack.
Yeah, if you just joined us, we are in game three of this Vixens title match. Sagira Wheeler has been averaging a 250, and that average may go up after this game. Meanwhile, Hermy, all she's got is four in a row and a nine spare.
Oh,
and that ball looks good too if it'll hold on. Does not. Seven pin.
It's that tight line. I think she just might need to make a little bit of a move on that right hand lane.
Yeah, unfortunately, and we've said this before, middle of the game, she leaves something up there. That's unfortunate because she was trailing before, and now she's really trailing. And we know she's going to make the spare.
Yep.
Beep. But now, and I say this because it's getting early late, we're in the seventh frame, best she can do is a 269. And right now, she's going to be 31 pins short.
Yep.
Right now, we'll feel like, based on the music, everybody's watching Sagira at this point. Hannibal, right now, seventh frame. Obviously, this has got to be a strike. This went really
That was unfortunate. That looked like it picked up at the arrows.
Yep.
Red early, went through the nose. Given her an
you hate to say the game is over in the seventh frame, but the game is over in the seventh frame.
Yeah, that was a very unfortunate leave.
Yeah, she needed to have a double and not that type of double. So Hermy 156 and 7, she can go out the door for 246. 246 usually very good against a heavyweight. Not very good right now against Sagira Wheeler.
Nope.
Who's got the front six. And here we go with number seven. Seven shot here. That ball's got a lot of anger behind it. And there we go.
She's progressing it really nicely. The ball's going through the pins really well.
She's not worried about her thumb now, is she?
She's not worried about the thumb now. I don't think so.
No, anything that happened before has currently gotten out of her mind. There's two things right now that's on her mind: throwing another strike and strangling the person that caused her to lose focus in the middle of game two. Ball looks good. A little bit high. She gets a nine.
Trips a nine pin.
Down it goes. Not thrilled about that. Three claps. Looking around. Yeah, everything fell down. Front eight for Sagira Wheeler. And it's ironic, the lyric that just came out. And I'll just say this. I wonder who's watching me now, the IRS. And for those that have figured it out at this point, that's there. And right now she's looking to cash in and... Seven pins looking to cash out Hermy this game.
I think Hermy's getting frustrated with the lack of carry here. She's hitting the pocket and just not getting the return that Sagira is.
No, not right now. And she's got to figure out something very, very quickly. She's got three frames to figure it out. Hermy right now, the best that she can do, got 236. Her coach, by the way, we haven't mentioned her coach at all. Her coach right now, all he's doing is sitting there in the back, shrugging his shoulders, because there's really nothing you can do at this point.
Nope, he's taking it easy.
Yeah, coach is saying, this is a massacre happening right now. And I say coach, I'm referring to, of course, anybody that's seen a Hermy Hannibal match. Oh, there's
a
strike.
There we go, that's a good strike.
Anybody that sees a Hermy Hannibal match, coach is from Lights Out, Curtis Warren. Him and I have done a number of broadcasts together in terms of me chatting with him and hanging out. Right now, there's nothing much to say at this point.
There's not. We're just going to watch and enjoy the show that Sagira is putting on here.
We'll be chatting about what Curtis Warren said momentarily. However, here we go. Ninth frame. Here's a shot. Looks good. Temper goes down.
She's not happy with it, but...
She may not be happy with the next three shots that she's there, except it may not matter. She can be very grumpy at this point. She'll be a little bit happier if she hits the next three. And again, we're not going to mention potentially what could be happening, even though we do have a couple of people watching and notating going, what's going on here? What's going on here is someone that so far has averaged 250 in this match, and that average is certainly going to go up after this game. 10th frame, first ball. Ball looks buried. It is.
That was a great shot.
10 in a row.
I think she threw that a lot more confidently. She looked a lot happier with that shot.
She does.
She's maybe just a little bit more comfortable on the left-hand lane.
Yeah, she needs to bowl more with teams for somebody to call in a protest against her team. Anything riled her up, that did. Actually, it's a really good point. She's going for an 800 right now if she goes out the door. Thinking about that. That ball looks nice. It is.
A brilliant shot.
So one more will be that magical number, plus the 500 after game two would be an 800 series over three games. We're not mentioning that number because, again,
we're not going to ruin this.
We're absolutely not. And again, if you're on Caffeine TV, this is a treat. I believe this is the first one that's going on Caffeine TV. If you turn on this one, you're not disappointed. First shot here, going for 300. Get up, it does. Sakura Wheeler, 300 games.
300 and an 800 series
for the first three games of this matchup. You didn't know that, did you?
Is that a PB?
800 series, 300 game for Sagira Wheeler.
She's scratching her head like she doesn't believe it happened.
And Herbie just said, my butt hurts right now. I hate to say that there's one more game in this match, so your butt could be hurting
more. There is at least one more game. She can still mount a comeback.
She absolutely could. It has happened before. There have been Vixens that have come back from 3-0 to win.
Shot.
However, and Hermia said this right now, 267 average for Sagira Wheeler after three games. So we're going into game four. Obviously, there's four games left. Hermia's got to win all of them. The margin of error is zero, a.k.a. El Cheapo. And, you know, I joked around and saying, what happens if Sagira Wheeler hits 1,000 over four? If she doesn't hit 1,000, it would be a major disappointment, wouldn't you think, at this point?
I think any bowler would be disappointed if they can go 805 for the first three and not make a 195.
First three, and then yeah.
Yeah. So Hermie's ball there.
I mean, she got so out focused, to the right. She just stared at me. Did you even realize that you shot an 800 series?
No.
Nope.
But that's the way you want it to be. You just want to be in the moment throwing the shots. You're not counting the scores.
Yeah.
So it's a 223 for Hermie.
Yeah, at the end of game three, 300 for Sagira, 223 for Hermie.
Any other time is a respectable score.
Any other time, the way that she's bowling, Hermie probably wins at least two of those games, except right now she's bowling Miss 267 average at this moment. And there's not much you can do about that.
So the question
Hermie's doing musical gear equipment change at this moment.
Can Sagira manage her emotions now that she's just hit that big score?
Oh, here we go. Looking for 13 in a row, technically.
Buries it in the pocket.
Actually, more than 13 in a row. We're looking at 20 in a row at this point because, see, she ended with a six-bagger game two, I believe. So now we're looking.
This is a lot of strikes.
Yeah. She's throwing a lot of strikes. We have them right now.
There we go. Hermie's.
There it is.
So Hermie's fell ball on that lane. She threw it a little bit right. The ball didn't pick up, didn't make it back to the pocket. It looks like she's moved a little bit left with it, just to try and maybe give it a bit more oil, get it through the lane a bit more and give it a chance to hook into the pins.
One thing that Hermie needs to be really happy about is that World Championship Series matches do not include overall wood, because she ain't winning that. However, she could win four games. And right
there we
now,
go.
She's got first time in this match, Hermie has started with the double.
With it, yes. Yes, that's big.
That is big, putting pressure on Sagira early. Hermie's dancing around. She's having fun. I'm having fun. You having fun?
Yeah, I'm having fun.
Sagira, I think if she wasn't frustrated by other things going on, would be having fun right
yes.
now. Absolutely. Wonder if Tony's having fun. This is the first one. First 300 for Caffeine TV, Tony. You having fun? Yeah, he's like, yeah.
He is.
All right, first shot here from Sagira, looking for 21 in a row.
Again, that right-hand lane just not looking quite as good as the left-hand lane for Sagira.
Curtis is saying, next time I'll borrow turn on three, so we'll chat a little bit. So Curtis is saying, next time you bowl her, take her phone so she can't look at her messages.
And it looks like we're lost the ball at the end of the lane, so we've got a little breakdown here.
Oh. So Sagira's pointing to her watch, meaning that she actually got the messages through the watch and not the phone. So now you got to take the phone, take the watch. Cover the paper. Cover the watch up with the paper. So we're enjoying ourselves right now. Now, the one thing that Curtis Warren did say, and he's absolutely right, and if you're a Yankee fan, you may want to cover yours on this. There have been baseball. There have been times that a team has come back from 3-0 to win 4-3, like the Red Sox did in 2004 to the Yankees. Curtis, I believe, is a Red Sox fan, if I remember correctly. Oh, you're a Yankee fan. Oh, you're lamenting.
I'm a Met fan.
You're a Met fan. You don't have to worry about that. Mets actually have to get to the playoffs in order for them to lose series. Oh. Now we're talking about Jets and football. It could be a Jets fan. Anybody know? Are the Jets playing right now?
I don't know, but I think they've got past four plays.
So Carl's talking about the Jets are getting past four plays. Ooh, we're being vicious here. But I will mention, I know we're not doing UBH trivia, we're not giving out anything. But I do remember a number of years ago, Unholy Alliance, where Stacey Breeze was up 3-0 and she lost 4-3 to Candace Little. Who won? What? Oh, okay. Well, then there you go. Oh, you're down 3-1. You came back to win. So it's a little bit better than 3-0, but you can. I mean, I've been down 3-0. I've come back to win. There's other people down 3-0. They've come back to win. So, you know, and then I'm sure as people on Caffeine TV are saying, wait a second, Gordon Bowles. Once in a while, Gordon Bowles. Once in a while, Gordon, were you alive? Oh, very nice. Thank you. Were you alive? I don't know if you were alive when I was bowling.
I'm your teammate on Monday.
I know. You're my teammate. We're currently in the top five, or top six in our league out of 30 teams. I'd like to point that out. So we're less than a week out of first. I'd like to point that out, too. We could take – and by the way, we are bowling the first-place team, so if we sweep, we take over first. Ooh.
Ooh,
we want to sweep,
big
by the way.
Match.
Ooh. That'll be fun. All right, looks like the gates come up. We're going to see if the ball returns come back.
The ball's back.
I'm sure there's all sorts of chatting right now. Wait, Gordon Bowles? What, he actually – what? So I've actually, once in a while, I actually win things, occasionally, sometimes. Nothing that's got PBA attached to it, but it's okay. So anyway, right now, if you just tuned in, where have you been? You may want to hit rewind a little bit, especially like 10 minutes ago, and then you'll understand what we're talking about at this point.
So here we go.
Let's put it this way. Possible 22 in a row for Sagira Wheeler. Sagira's up 3-0.
We've had a little breakdown on the lanes.
Josh, come over here. I'm doing all right. How you doing, Josh?
I just drove to the wrong bowling alley, and then I came here, so.
What bowling alley did you drive to?
I went to Westbrook first.
Yeah, Hamilton and Westbrook, sure. Oh. They're close to each other. And, by the way, 22 strikes in a row for Sagira Wheeler.
I would have loved to see it if I would have got here 45 minutes ago.
Let's put it this way. We're sort of chatting about this. I'm not sure that you'd want to be going up against Segura at this moment.
No, I wouldn't want to go against her. I just wanted to see it.
Right now, Hermie looking to tie this up 3 in a row, and she will.
That was a great shot from
everywhere.
Hermie.
I'm sorry, yeah. You go.
The girls are both coming out really strong this game. Hermie is do or die. She's got to win this one to stay in it. Segura dealt with that breakdown really well. Didn't seem to put her out of her stride at all. She just got straight up there and threw a strike.
Hannibal right now, 4 in a row. That Bullock's Berry too.
There we go. Yeah, Hermie's locked in now.
Yeah, by the way, if you went against either Vixen right now, you'd be dealing against that.
I know. They're really good. I would not want to be in that division at all.
Right now, I don't want to be in this group.
and this is one of the reasons why I've said this since the game one. This is why I enjoy covering Vixen's matches more than heavyweight matches. It's not that I don't enjoy heavyweight or cruiserweight. I just know that I'm going to get this in a Vixen's match.
Looks like... Oh, no. Yep.
Yep, 23 in a row? 23 in a row! With the 7 pin coming down. We're tied 4 apiece. And we are in game 4, and this is a game Hermie absolutely must win, or we will have a new Vixen's champion in that belt, as it's been quite frequently during the number of years that it's been around. We'll go right back down to the DMV.
So we think this
Vixen
might be
loves the DMV.
Her 24th strike in a row, which would be two back-to-back Very Papas.
Yeah, really. 24 in a row? Yes,
yeah.
24 in a row for Segura Wheeler.
I feel like she threw that a tad fast, didn't quite shape the lane
well.
She's shaking her head walking off the lane.
We've got 9 strikes in a row in this game. What? Yeah. Hermie Han, that ball's a little bit high. Oh, he gets it anyway.
Wow.
That ball does not move. 10 strikes in a row in this game. And again, if you're on Caffeine TV watching this live, I really hope you're watching this right now. This is fun time.
This is incredible bowling. Both ladies 5 for 5. Segura's up 3 games to 0.
Yeah, by the way, she's averaging 267. That may go up after this game. Looking for 6 in a row. And that ball
there
looks
we go.
Good, and it is.
So it looks like Hermie, who was lamenting her lack of carry in the first 3 games, has suddenly found something.
Yeah. But to say, I think she found something. Maybe I inspired her talking about me actually, but no, I'm pretty sure it's not that.
So for me, the right-hand lane, Segura's last couple of shots have been a little bit iffy, not quite as good as on the left-hand lane, so let's see what happens with this shot.
Yeah, maybe somebody needs to call and yell at her again or say the protest on her team. Be 25.
She's throwing that.
Oh, my goodness. Let's do the math here. 9. Yeah, 25 in a row. Looking for 26 in a row. Oh, by the way, we're tied after 6 frames. That doesn't seem to be the story in this one, but it should be. Now, I'm not going to say anything in terms of what we're discussing, but possible roll off based on that could be fun. Yeah, that's been the only mistake that she's made. She dropped the ball and went backwards. Looking for 26 in a row for Segura Wheeler.
Much
we get
better ball
it.
On that left-hand lane.
26 in a row for Segura. 13 strikes in a row in this game.
I'm sure she doesn't want us to be reminding her of these stats.
I'm not sure she cares. Gotta remember, I gotta chat about this stuff for the hundreds of thousands of people that are watching this match. And that will be watching this match because there need to be. Hermie Hannibal right now looking at the strike.
There we go.
Frame. It keeps up. 14 strikes in a row in this game.
Yeah, that's incredible. It looks like the right-hand lane might be opening up a little bit for Hermie there. She had a bit more shape on that ball. It wasn't quite as tight as some of her other shots have been.
Josh Valdez just said he'll be right back. He needs to hurry very quickly.
This game's going to be over before he's back, the way these ladies are going.
Or maybe it not, may not be over. He could be doing 2-frame roll-off. 8-3 for Hermie. That ball looks good.
That was buried.
That was no doubt about it. A call from the peanut gallery. Where was that 3 games ago?
I'm sure Hermes like,
just sat there with a head
too.
In her hand, so she agrees with him.
Got Company B playing in the background. It's one of my favorite songs. The song that, it's a great song. Yeah, well, the song is called Fascinated, and anybody who's watching this right now, it's going to be very fascinated. 27 in a row, maybe.
So
no.
Segura made a move there. She made a move. She moved it in, laid it down a bit further in the middle of her lane to try and pick up a bit more oil. It didn't quite come off how she was hoping, but she still hasn't left anything lower than a 9.
Right. How crazy is this going to be for me to be saying this? Her streak ended at 26 in a row, and she's going to lose the game because of it. How crazy is that potentially being? She'll make this
better. Is it good? Yep.
Yeah, if she goes out the door, it's only for 279. And I say only because that will just barely go over our average in terms of this. And more importantly, her opponent's got the front 8.
So that was a bold move she made on the right-hand lane, but I think it was a good move. She had to be a bit more aggressive on that right-hand lane.
Well, she switched shots. However, she can be shut out right now.
And on that left-hand lane, Segura swapped to her Envy Tor.
How crazy would that be? I'm not going to say anything. But you know what I'm thinking right now.
Don't say it. Don't even think it.
Too late. I'm thinking it. Ninth frame, Hermie Hannibal. That ball looks good. Also, it is. Front 9 for Hermie Hannibal as we go into the 10th frame.
Both of these ladies showing incredible ability to deal with the pressure here.
Yeah, I'll say the obvious here. A strike and the game's over. 9 spare strike could potentially be a tie. Anything less than that, this match could end. Here you go, 10th frame. That ball looks light.
Just got it out a little bit to the right. It just hung, didn't quite come back into the pocket right.
Now all of a sudden, this went from potential 300 to potential match over.
Yes. And that shot that Segura threw in the 9th where she changed ball could be a pivotal moment.
That could be a huge ball change right there. Now, that's also a very huge spare right there. Hermie goes out the door, and assuming that she wills, it's 277, throwing the strike. This is going to sound familiar. Strike, 9 for Segura, and it will be game, set, match.
There's that strike she wanted in the other ball.
Hermie, all of a sudden, she may be regretting that move for a very, very long time. How crazy is this? This is a crazy game.
It is a crazy game. It's a crazy match.
Yes.
And these ladies are throwing so many high pressure shots, and this is just even more.
First ball, gotta have it.
So that Envy Tor, great ball.
Have been going down. So next strike, gotta have that also. And that 267 average will go up. That's what that first strike means.
And she's easily secured her 1,000 for four.
Oh, yeah. Almost 1,100.
Yep.
Second shot. Got to have this one also.
Yeah.
Does. Here's what it comes down to. If she throws a strike or a 9, we have a new Northeast Vixens champion. Ooh. If she throws an 8, which, by the way, she has not done the entire match,
We
have a tie. Anything less than that, we get a game 5. So that basically, Curtis just said, we are hoping for her to do something she has not done the whole entire day today. This is for game, set, match. Got it.
Excellent.
We have a new
Excellent.
Northeast Vixens champion, and well-deserved. Congratulations to Segura Wheeler, who once again wins the belt, and for her, second title reign. Waiting to get the stats momentarily. Right now, I want to chat with Segura.
And we're going to have a little chatsky over here after Segura gets a belt. All right. I was told we got to go up there, so we got to go up there. All right, let's see. Where do we start over here? Where do we start? So you averaged over 270 for the match.
That's it.
Team Hammer.
Yeah, Team Hammer. Yeah, you were doing some hammering, all right. Averaged 270 for the match. You had 26 strikes in a row at one point. You had 800 series, by the way, the 300, which I thought you were going to almost do again. And then you got this thing over here. Talk to me a little bit.
About?
Well, first of all, this pink thing over here.
It's nice to be back home. It's nice for it to be back home.
Uh-huh. So tell me, without mentioning names, because we're not going to mention any names, but did the, let's just say, thing that happened earlier, was that a motivator? Did that give you a little bit of an extra kick of adrenaline?
Not extra kick of adrenaline. A little bit annoying, but I'm going to leave it here at this point because I'm over it. But not distracting, no. I'm used to multitasking because life goes on, so. But yeah.
Life goes on, and that's what you do. So, we got a little thing here. That's your average, 271 average, by the way.
I have to post that.
We don't have to. Only a couple hundred thousand people are just watching and paying attention, making notes on that. That's all.
Well, thank you. Thank you for watching Caffeine TV, UBA all day.
Absolutely. Any other final thoughts you want to say, even though I think you summarized that quite nicely?
We're in Jersey, so pizza, and then off to home.
Pizza at home, and then all of a sudden people got to come over here to take that belt coming down to DMV.
It'll be a while.
Ooh, it'll be a while.
All right.